In this video, we're looking at a couple qualitative examples of electromagnetic induction. So as a quick reminder, the way electromagnetic induction works is that a current, or at least a potential difference, will be induced in a coil in the direction that reduces a change in flux, in other words, the change of magnetic field through that coil. So for part A, I have this coil of wire, and its terminals are hooked up to this loop of wire that has a resistor in it, and we're asked which way is the induced current going to flow in that resistor. And so what happens in this part is that a magnetic field is turned on pointing into the page. So there's the new magnetic field that we've exposed this loop to, and the loop is going to respond by producing magnetic field out of the page in order to minimize that change in flux. So I'll call that B induced. Then we just have to think about the Ampere's law right-hand rule and ask which way does the current have to flow in this coil in order to produce outward pointing field lines through the coil. And if we align our thumb like this, curl the fingers of our right hand around, our fingers are going to poke out of the page as we go through the interior of the loop. So it looks like a counterclockwise current through this loop produces those induced outward magnetic field lines that are trying to reduce the change in flux. Well, counterclockwise current through the loop means downward current on the left branch, upward current on the right branch, and through the resistor in this little loop, the current points to the right. Now in part B, we have a solenoid setup, so that's just another type of coil. It's just a long and skinny one. And we're approaching this solenoid with the south pole of a permanent magnet. And we have to remember that the field lines of a permanent magnet point toward the south pole and away from the north pole. So as we're approaching this coil with the south pole of the magnet, we're introducing new magnetic field lines pointing left through the coils of the solenoid. This means the induced magnetic field is going to point to the right through those coils in order to reduce the change in flux. So B induced points to the right there. And then we have to think about which way does current flow in this solenoid in order to produce rightward magnetic field through its interior. So again, we use our right-hand rule for Ampere's law. And if we align the thumb of our right hand so that we're pointing down this adjacent face of the solenoid, and then curl the fingers of our right hand around, our fingers are going to curl to the right on the interior of this solenoid. So current is flowing down the face, down the near side of this solenoid. And that means if I look at the branch on the left side, current is going this way. And if I look at the branch on the right side, current is flowing up and through the resistor in between. Current is again flowing to the right. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.